Hey guys, so today's video is going to make you save a ton of time when it comes to skin tones. I want to show you one of the main tricks that I use when I want to try some new skin tones on my character, especially on characters that you already created the values or the colors. Like in this case, this one is in color, but what I mean by values is that if you do a black and white illustration like this, the technique I'm going to show you today would work as well. So basically what we're going to do is the first thing that you want to do to do this trick is to make a selection of the skin. So in this case, I got my arm here, I got the face, a little bit of the chest and this arm. So what you want to do is make a selection. You can make the selection the way you want to. Usually I use the pen tool, but any kind of lasso tool such as the polygonal lasso tool would work as well. As long as the end result looks like this. So I have a selection of my skin tone. And once you got the selection like this, what you want to do is go over your layers and you want to go over your adjustment layers, which is the circle half black, half white at the bottom here. You want to click on it. It's going to open a panel and you want to choose gradient maps. Now, when the gradient map is going to appear, it's going to give you a default gradient map. And as you can see right now, it's going to give me a bizarre result, but it's fine. We're gonna change that result in a second. What it did with selection is created a mask, and as you can see here, the mask is basically just a black and white mask that will allow me to make an effect with the gradient map, but not have an effect on the rest of my illustration. So I'm just gonna close this here. Basically, what I want to do with this here is create skin tones, and I want to create skin tones from pictures. So here what I have is three different skin tones. I got two portrait and a piece of shoulder here. And I want to show you how easy and fast it's going to be for me to change my skin tones. And I'm going to explain you as well the process of doing it. So the first thing you want to do once you're here, it's double click on your gradient map. So I'm going to double click. It's going to open this property panel. And then you want to double click on the actual gradient. And from here, I can close this. Once the gradient editor, which is this window, appears, if you never did anything with this, you'll have the default gradient that Photoshop gives you. The two first one being created by the selected color that you have. So right now I have a green and a white. If I had different color, those first two would be different. Then you got a black and white, which is the one I'm going to click on right now. As you can see, it's going to change my skin tone back to a gradient map. If I click on any of them, it's going to change it to this, and it's going to give some funky results sometimes. The idea here is to be able to modify them. So I'm going to click on the black and white for starters, and I'm going to explain a little bit more about the gradient editor here. So first of all, you got presets of gradients here, and you got names for each of them. And basically what we're going to use today is here, is the gradient that you see here. What's important to know is the two arrows at the bottom. They change the colors. So right now, if I move this, you'll see that it's going to make changes on my skin tone here. And basically what I'm going to do is change those arrows from those skin tones to create new skin tones. So the first thing I'm going to do is click on the black here, and I'm going to try with the first one here. And what you want to do is take the darkest skin tone that this illustration has, photo has here. So I'm clicking here on the fold of the eyelid, which is a really dark place. Then you want to click in the middle, and it's going to add a new arrow. And you want to change that arrow to something that it's mid value. So I'm going to double click on the color here so I can see mid value would be like in the middle here. And I'm going to click around here and try to find something that is closer to mid value. And I think that is closer to mid value. I'm going to click OK. And the white, I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to take the highest value that I see, which is probably the highlight on her nose right here. So from here, I created a new skin tone variation with the gradient map. What I'm going to do is add just a little bit more colors to it. So I'm going to try to pick something in the middle of this and the mid-tone. I'm going to click here, add a new arrow, and I'm going to try to add something that it's dark enough to fit in the middle, like this. And I'll do the same here. Something like that. So it's going to give me just a little bit more to play with. From here, what's important is to play with the arrows to actually adjust the skin tone. Obviously, right now, it seems a little bit bizarre. So what I'm going to do is just move the arrows that I've created to try to get a skin tone that looks natural. So I'm just gonna move them a little bit. I'm gonna try to get same kind of effect that I see here. By moving all those, it should get closer and closer. So I think that's pretty close. Just gonna move this here a little bit more. So I think this is pretty close here. So I create a new thing. Now, obviously what you're seeing right now is not exactly harmonious because it doesn't take in account the reflection of my green walls everywhere. So if I want to add that actually reflection of the green walls, I would have to add some green to that new skin tones that I created. So I'm just gonna double click again on here on my gradient map. And what I'll do is add a little bit more green to my tones. I'm gonna click on this mid value here. I'm gonna click on the color. It's gonna open the color picker. And what I'm gonna do is add a little bit of cyan and yellow, which is blue and yellow, basically. And it's gonna add a little bit more green to this color. So what I can do is just click in the box and use my key arrow and just press up a little bit. It's gonna add a little bit of blue. And I'm gonna do the same thing with the yellow. And it's gonna give just a little bit more greenish to that color. So if you wanna see the difference here, I'm gonna do Command Z. And you can see it just added a bit of the green tone. So now this skin tone is also taking the relation with the background, which it's making more fit to my illustration here. And just like that, I've been able to create a new skin tone. Now, if I want to keep it, I could actually keep it by making a new preset here. I would just have to give it a name and say skin tone green 1 and press new. And it's going to add it to here. Now, if you want to keep those presets and save them, you can also save them on your computer by pressing save. I won't do this for now, but it's an option that you could do as well. So as you can see, that has been really, really fast. And just like that, I've been able to change my skin tone. So I'll do it another time just to give you another example. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double click on my gradient map and I'm gonna go back to the grayscale. And this time I'm gonna try with this one. So I'm gonna click on the black again, take the darkest tone that I can see, just around here. I'll click in the middle, find something that it's mid-tone-ish, click on the highlights, and I'll try to find, again, tones that fit in the middle of those two. Sometimes it's going to be hard for you to find the mid-tone, so what you can do is just double-click on the color and just pick it up manually, and just like this, find something that's in the middle of them. I think it should be a little bit darker, actually. I'm going to click here, and I'll just pick up another tone here. And as you can see, this one is drastically different, and it's because the values are not placed the same way. There's more highlights on this face than is there. But I can fix that by just moving the arrows again. So I'm just going to move the arrows, and I will gain back this highlight. That's something a little bit closer. Once again, if I wanted to add a little bit of green, I would simply have to click on one of the colors and just add a little bit of cyan, a little bit of yellow, and it would give me just that greenish glow a little bit to make sure that this skin tone fits in the picture. So I'm gonna click again on new. I'll just give it skin tone 2 and I'll click new. And it's gonna add it there. I'm gonna click okay. Now it goes with every kind of skin tone. Obviously, if I wanna try the third one here, my character here is too white to actually get that skin tone. So what I can do actually to modify the skin tone and to make it match this, it's to change the value that I have. So right now my values are something like this, and I need something that's darker. So what I can do is just click on the adjustment layer once again, and just click on the levels, yeah. And this panel is going to pan. And what you can do is simply take the white arrow, the bottom right arrow, and bring it down like this to get the values a little bit more dark. And you want to play as well with those arrows here, just to bring everything closer. And what I'll do, I'll put just a mask on it, so it's going to affect only my skin tone. And as you can see now, I'm affecting just the skin tone, and I'm able to just play with the values of my skin tone to something that's closer to a darker skin. And if I go back to my colors, now you can see that it just modified my green. So what I'll do is I'm going to put the gradient map on top of this. And once again, I'm going to open my gradient map here. I'll put it to black and white, and I'm going to do the same operation now. I'll take the darkest skin tone that I can see. In the middle one, I'll take that orangey. And then I'll fit something in the middle of the two. Something here and something there. Now, if I want to modify this and get it closer, I'll have again to move the arrows. So what I can do is just move the arrows, because what I want to create as well is that highlight that is on the skin. So it's going to move everything to the left, and it's going to bring back that highlight. And just like that, I created a really dark skin. Now, obviously, this skin tone doesn't work with this character here. But you can see that any skin tone can be modified by just a few clicks. If you need something darker, you just change the levels. If you see, if I take out the levels, it's going to burn my skin completely. But with the levels now, it looks okay. But yeah, I'll go back to a skin tone, I guess, that fits better my character. And the one that I saved here, the first one here, I think was the best here. And that's it, guys. That's how you can change your skin tone in a matter of minutes. So have fun. Give it a try. Happy painting.